Welcome to this innovation coffee break focusing on power electronic simulation. Due to the energy transition and the electrification of the vehicle, the grid and the automotive components form one system. Thus, the number of power electronics increases as well as the complexity of the system, and consequently the interest in AGL simulation increases in the last years. Power electronic simulation is an ambitious task, so we have a high switching frequency, we have high dynamic compared to mechanical systems, the changing structure due to the power electronic devices or the semiconductors, the diversity of the circuit, so very different topologies, and as it is in all other domains where we reach the technical limits, we have to make a trade-off, and here I listed some conflicting effects. So when you want to have a high accuracy, this yields to a higher computation effort. The reduction of the computation effort usually yields to a higher memory consumption. And a memory and computation effort can be reduced by making simplifications and assumptions, but this reduces the applicability. And when we use this and put that in a radar chart, we can make a relative comparison of the dSPACE solutions. And here we have our three solutions. And what means relative comparison? As an example, we use the budget friendliness. So the ready-to-use model is more budget-friendly than the circuit-specific implementation. When we're taking a look on the specific advantages of each solution, we find out that the ready-to-use model is much more budget-friendly. It is simple to use. The circuit-specific implementation is used when we need the highest performance. It has the highest flexibility in respect to the modeling approach and the best FPGA utilization. Then we have a generic and easy-to-use tool. The modeling is based on the topology, so the highest flexibility is here when it is in respect to changes in the topology, and we do not need any synthesis or FPGA knowledge from the user. So, as I mentioned before, these solutions are available at dSPACE, and the big question is how we select the correct one. And therefore, I have an additional slide, and on the left we have the list of properties and information which helps us to select the appropriate solution. So when you have an application and you are interested in real-time simulation of power electronic circuits, just contact us and then we will find the correct solution for you. As an application example, we choose here a bidirectional DC-DC converter. This is in the mid-range of the usual frequency ranges, and this demo was realized with electrical power system simulation package, and it will be presented by Summer.
Thank you, Axel. Today I would like to show you a demo regarding a dual battery automotive system. This technology targets mild hybrid vehicles, which include an integrated starter generator. This bus system supplements the existing 12-volt lead-acid battery with another 48-volt lithium-ion battery. In addition, a bidirectional DC-DC converter bridges the two 12-volt and 48-volt systems. This converter can be used to charge either one of the two batteries, or it can also be used for power transfer from both batteries to the same load, if required. Here, for example, we have an evaluation board from a company. It is a bidirectional DC-DC converter. It is also equipped with a controller IC. However, to operate such a board, it can be dangerous if all the safety requirements are not met. Therefore, we have designed a hardware-in-the-loop simulation on signal level, where the controller IC is the device under test, and the plant model is the complete powertronic circuit. Now here you can see the complete circuit topology. The batteries have been replaced with simplified modules, with voltage sources and internal resistances. On the left side, you can see the 48-volt high side battery, and on the right side, the 12-volt lithium-ion battery. And both batteries are connected through a two-phase interleaved bidirectional DC-DC converter. In addition, there's some circuitry which can be used to measure the inductor current through DCR sensing or a shunt resistor. For our hardware-in-the-loop simulation, we are using a Skelexio lab box, which is a real-time platform produced by dSPACE. It has a processor board, FPGA board, which supports the small simulation step required for higher switching frequencies. The simulation steps can lie in the range of microseconds or lower. It also has FPGA I/O module boards. These boards act as interface between the simulator and the controller. The controller and the simulator need to be able to communicate with each other and to exchange signals and other measurements that are necessary for operation. To aid this, we have used a signal conditioning PCB. This PCB connects directly to the FPGA modules. This ensures that the controller can read the required voltages and current measurements that are required for control, and it can also supply the gate signals or other appropriate signals that are required by the plant model. The signal conditioning PCB also connects to a small piggyback PCB, which includes the controller IC. So in order to execute and operate our real-time simulation, we will use Control Desk, which is also a software produced by dSPACE. Here in Control Desk, the circuit topology and various measurements are displayed to help us visualize everything better. The measurements are displayed as numeric values and also in various plotters. This helps depict any errors or discrepancies. Right now, we are operating at a frequency of 50 kHz. The controller can also be operated in various operation modes, and the operation modes can be selected very easily through a drop-down menu here. For example, buck or boost mode, continuous conduction mode or discontinuous conduction mode, current control mode, or voltage control mode. As an example, I will take buck CCM voltage control first. As you can see, at the output, there are 0 volts right now. But when I enable the controller, the desired voltage can now be seen. This means that the controller is working and there is a power transfer from the high side to the low side. Similarly, when I take boost DCM voltage control mode and I enable the control, we will see the desired voltage, 48 volts, at the input capacitor. Similarly, these voltages can be seen in the plot here. As another example, I would like to show you buck CCM current control mode. Here in this graph, you can see that the red current follows the green current reference exactly. When I change it here, in addition to the normal plotters, we also have the FPGA plotter. The advantage of this plotter is that its timing resolution equals that of the FPGA clock. This means that you can also display your signals at a high resolution. For example, here we can see the two inductor currents flowing through the two phases. In addition, the phase shift is also visible here. Similarly, we can also look at the gate signals, the high side voltage, and the low side voltage in more detail. Similarly to what I have shown here, various other test conditions can also be simulated in real time. So this brings us to the end of this demo. If you have any questions regarding this demo or real-time simulation of hardware systems in general, please contact us.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.